Farewell. God knows when we shall meet again. I have a faint, cold fear thrills through my veins that almost freezes up the heat of life. I'll call them back again to comfort me. Nurse! What should she do here? My dismissal scenes needs must act alone. Come, vial. What if this mixture do not work at all? What if I'll be married then tomorrow morning? No, no. This shall forbid it. Lie thou there. What if it be a poison which the friar subtly hath ministered to have me dead? Then in this marriage he shall be dishonored because he married me before to Romeo. I fear it is, and yet methinks it not, for he hath still been tried a holy man. How if, when I lie in the tomb tomorrow, I wake up before the time that Romeo come to redeem me? There's a fearful point. Shall I not be then stifled in the vault to those foul mouth to hath helpless in, ere breathe in and there die strangled ere my Romeo comes? Or if I live, is it not the very likely the buried conceit of death and night, together with the terror of the place as in a vault, ancient receptacle, where for this many hundred years the bones of all my buried ancestors are packed, where bloody Tybalt yet but green in earth lies festering in his shroud, where, as they say, at some hours in the night spirits resort. Alack, alack, it is not like that I, so early waking, what with eye pathsome, smells and shrieks like mandrakes torn out of the earth, that living mortals rearing them run mad. Oh, if I wake, shall I not be distraught, environed with all these hideous fears, and madly play with my forefathers' joints, and pluck the mangled Tybalt from his shroud, and in this rage, with some great kinsman's bone, as with a club dash out, not distant rest, desperate brains. Oh, look, methinks I see my cousin's quest, seeking out Romeo, that did not spit his body upon a rapier's point. Stay, Tybalt, stay. Romeo, Romeo, Romeo. I drink to thee.